He is still undefeated. He is now the WBA and WBC Unified Welterweight Champion of the World. Keith, one time, Thurman.
Top three reasons why Keith Thurman run this fight? Very simple. Reason number one, effective aggression. First round, he came out aggressive. He put it on Danny, using that jab to find him as a ranger, overhand right. Number two, ring generalship. The way he circled around the ring, whenever Danny did become the aggressor, he became the counterpuncher and used every corner, every inch of that ring like a young Sugar Ray Leonard, you know what I'm saying? Number three, accuracy. He threw more, landed more. Danny threw less, landed less. And simply put, those are the top three reasons why this man easily got an 8-4, 9-3 and why he should easily either get Keith Thurman versus, I don't know, Errol Spence or Kell Brook winner, or a hometown fight with maybe Collazo in lieu to see what happens with these four welterweights, Berto and Porter, Brook and Spence. Those are my top three reasons, Enrique.
Let me go with my top three reasons why Danny Garcia deserves a rematch.
Go for it.
Even though I scored a 7-5, right? He's not a true welterweight, Keith Thurman said. Danny fought like a welterweight against Keith Thurman, the true welterweight. KOs for life. This is reason number two. Did Thurman score a KO? I mean, he twisted Danny, showed that Danny has a chin. Danny fought on all 12 rounds against a welterweight. Number one, Brooklyn. Barclay Center. Celebrities.
The crowd.
Fighters. People traveled West Africa, Australia, Paris, right? Rob is from Paris or London?
UK.
UK. All over the world showed up. Pro, Danny, and there were a lot of Thurman fighters, fans rather. They deserve a rematch because it's a big payday for both of them again. Immediately.
Highest payday.
Highest payday. They did great numbers. They were expecting 9-10, what Thurman did.
5.1 million viewers.
5.1 million viewers. I would say that's an excellent. Now they both know each other, right? So a rematch would be even more explosive. Maybe we'll get that KO.
Some are saying this fight is forgettable.
I want to say that. You see, those first three rounds are most memorable rounds for about 10 years.
In your opinion, did this fight live up to the hype?
I would say yes. For me, yes. I enjoyed this fight on person, in person, and on television.
I agree. I think that a large amount of our fan base came out to this one. Brooklyn was electric. We've never seen the Barclay Center with 16,500, and they had that. I know, you know, the thing is that people were expecting the knockout from Thurman.
Right.
But hardcore fans, we knew that he was a boxer. He's boxed all his life. That's what he does. He did it in the Chavez fight, even though he got the stoppage. But when Chavez put it on him, he boxed.
He hits hard.
He does hit hard.
He didn't score the knockout.
He didn't.
Danny Garcia, Keith
But
Durbin
neither did
too.
Danny.
Right.
His father kept saying, oh, he can't take it to the body. When Danny hit him to the body.
Well, he folded up.
He ain't folded go down.
Up right at the bell.
He ain't go down.
He folded up another time against the ropes and skipped away, skipped to my loo, right?
I mean, you want to say skipped to my loo, I seen this.
Oh, he dabbed on him? He dabbed. Round one. Yo, if you like this video, you want more of this video,
hit that
video,
thumbs up.
Hit the thumbs up, share it, post it, like it, tweet about it, and Facebook it.
That's right.
Right? And hashtag TBV Podcast.
Overhand right. Boop! Bye.